Today we are going to learn upon a new topic, that is soil. Soil is something which is present all around us. We all have played in the soil. You must have played with toys made up of soil. So today we'll learn about the importance of soil, about the process of formation of soil. What is soil composed of? So have you ever wondered if there would have been no soil, then we would not be able to get food, because plants grow in soil and we are obtaining food, oxygen, raw materials from the plants. So soil is a very important natural resource. Soil is the uppermost layer of the earth's crust. It is a mixture of various sizes of particles which are mixed together, and it also contains lot of dead and decaying matter which is called as the humus. So soil is a mixture which contains air, water, dead and decaying matter, and countless living organisms are present in the soil. How does soil formation occurs? You will be amazed to know that even a single inch of soil takes thousands of years to form. Soil formation is also called as weathering. Weathering is the process of formation of soil from the rocks. So here three different processes are involved. First is mechanical weathering, or you can say physical weathering. It is breaking down of the larger rock particles into the smaller ones due to some physical processes. It could be like freezing of the rocks and expanding of the rocks due to the heat of the sun, and at the night time, because of the decline in the temperature, the rocks contract, and during the daytime, because of the heat of the sun, the rocks are expanding. So this continuous expansion and contraction of the rocks can lead to breakage of the rocks. Next is chemical weathering. Chemical weathering here involves a chemical reaction that can cause the rock to break and dissolve, forming new substances. It could occur because of the presence of the chemicals, presence of the minerals in the rocks, and when the rainwater reacts with these minerals, it leads to the formation of new substances. Next is biological weathering. It is disintegration or breaking of the rocks due to the action of plants and animals. It could occur due to the roots of the plants which are expanding in the cracks of the rocks, or it could be because of certain secretions from certain animals like lichens. They grow on the rock surface. So when they are growing, they will release certain chemical substances. So this comes under biological weathering. Uses of soil. As I've already told you, we require soil to grow plants. So indirectly, we are getting our food, clothing and shelter from the soil. Soil is used as a construction material. Then we can obtain lot of minerals from the soil. And soil is a big source of underground water. If I talk about types of soil, we have clayey soil, sandy soil, silt and loam soil. Loam is a mixture of all the three, clay, sandy and silt particles. Now coming to soil profile. Soil profile is a vertical cross section of a portion of soil which shows us the different layers of the soil. Here now in soil profile, you can find, you can easily study the soil profile. If you have seen a pit somewhere nearby your area, it shows the different colored layers of the soil. So the top layer is called as the O-horizon, which is rich in humus, where the green plants, they grow. Next is the topsoil. In the topsoil only, O-horizon is also there, and the topsoil contains rich organic matter, because all the dead and decaying matter, it is going to be fall and mixed in the topsoil itself. Next to the topsoil is the subsoil. Subsoil is draining from above, accumulates in the B-horizon. See, the topsoil is also called as the A-horizon. Above to the topsoil, we have the O-horizon, and below to the topsoil, we have the B-horizon, that is the subsoil. It has finer particles if you compare it to the parent material. What is parent material here? It is the C-horizon. It is partly weathered rock. If you go further below, we have bedrock, or you can say the R-horizon. Bedrock is the layer of the imporous rocks which doesn't allow the water to flow beyond it. So whenever there is a flow of water, or you can say the rain water, if absorbed by the soil, it will percolate down through the different layers and get collected at the bedrock. there it forms the layer of underground water. So we have learned today the uses of soil, the importance of soil, and the process of weathering, that is formation of the soil. So weathering can occur by biological method, chemical or physical means. Then we learned about layers of the soil, that is the soil profile. Each layer of the soil is called as horizon. So if we start from the top, we have the O horizon, then we have the A horizon, that is topsoil, which is highly fertile, rich in organic matter. Then we have the subsoil, and that is B horizon. Next is the parent material or the C horizon, and last is the bedrock, which consists of imporous rocks. So the water will not flow beyond that, and water table starts forming there at this level. So this much for today. Thank you.